Alright guys, what's going on? We're here to talk to you
How's it?
guys about a Dragon's Lair. I'm
That's right,
Slam,
Dragon
this
Slayer.
is Jake right here. Sorry for cutting you
Yep, we got
off.
Slam and Skits back again, and we're gonna talk about Dragon's Lair, one of the most classic arcade games ever known to the earth. Isn't that right?
And I actually know the history behind this game. It's actually surprising. Like I
Too.
actually have interest in the history behind this thing, maybe because a movie
There's
person,
a
but
reason why, and that's why.
yeah, that is why.
That is why.
So I guess this game was made by Don Bluth. Like, he was the art coordinator and all that. He was the director of the thing. This whole game's pretty much like reminds me of like one of those movie games, like maybe a bonus feature on a movie or something that's like, oh hey, you want to go here or you want to go there? You have like your choice or whatever. It's kind of funny. Is Dragon
It's
Slayer
kind
making
of
you tired?
no, sorry, I just had a random yawn there, folks, but I'm good. I was gonna say that Dragon's Lair falls into the category of what we call a full motion video type of game. I believe it might have been the first, as far as I know.
Yeah, like I've seen some interviews with Don Bluth about this game,
Yeah.
hence on the Nostalgia Critic and what have you. Y'all. Anyway, apparently he didn't even know how to make a game, so he was just like creating a good story and like making all these like different like things, I guess. Like he was directing this like he was directing a movie, but then he had the I guess the game element of it later, I guess, which is kind of funny, but then kind of true if you know who Don Bluth is. He directed like The Land Before Time, American Tail, The Secret of Nim, those types of animated movies that are classics and very well directed movies, I gotta say. And this is a very well directed game.
It
I
is.
thoroughly enjoyed it. I would thoroughly enjoy it if I didn't even know what this game was. Like, this game is. I'm geeking out about this. This game is, like, super sick. It's
It
like.
is fun. It really is.
It's
It's
like
just
a.
it's
It's like a
hard.
move. Oh, yeah, it is hard. You know why it's hard? I'm so excited to just tell you about this history. You know why it's hard, right?
Why is it hard, man? Tell them why it's hard.
Because apparently the game developers thought that it would be too easy for some reason. Like, you
Huh.
just like, you know, the flashing light, it tells you where to go. Many people thought it'd be too boring or too easy, so they intentionally made it very, very difficult. Like, that stupid flashing light, like, you gotta know like exactly where to go, and like they switch it up on you every so often.
Yep.
Like, they mix up like the whatever the they mix up the levels, I guess, where like the little like story things, you gotta remember like what you did, you remember it, take notes on it, because if you don't remember it, you will die. And there's some things in
Yeah.
here that's like intentionally supposed to throw you off, like the drink me thing. I got that a couple times.
I remember that one.
Yeah.
I saw some Linden disintegration on that ancient CRT monitor that day.
Yeah, even though I never played the game before, even though I knew that you're supposed to not drink the thing when it says drink me, but I drink it anyway. It was just like a sometimes just like a split second thing, so you know? It's just super
Gotta
weird.
think fast.
Yeah. So what? I'm sorry. I'm running my mouth because I absolutely adore this game. What do you think about this game?
Well,
Let's have a real gamer give your opinion on it.
yes, sure. As an arcade collector and enthusiast, it's a game that's very legendary, without a doubt, and it's very hard to find, though, because a lot of times, It used a Laserdisc player in it, because there aren't any sprite graphics. It's got a Laserdisc that has all the animation on it.
You mean like the ones like that big huge record?
That's exactly right. Like the massive disc, that thing.
So you gotta pop that thing in and it plays and all that type of thing?
Yeah, that's how it works.
The heck? That is.
It'd be hard to make that work otherwise. Maybe they could use a VHS tape, but that would not have been reliable enough.
Oh no. I wouldn't even know how you would move a thing without it getting broken. Like every time you move it, it'd probably break.
Move the machine?
What?
You mean like moving the machine?
Yeah, moving the machine to like those like arcades or like pizza
Huh.
places or whatever, wherever they might be. Just pop
Actually,
them in.
that was a common problem. That was the biggest flaw. That did happen a lot, actually.
Yeah, no wonder. Dadgummit.
So, you have to, you gotta keep them, very, very safe. And I would recommend if, for whatever reason, you're gonna move a Dragon's Lair, take the laser disc out and don't waste the laser disc because I'm not totally certain if they reproduce the disc or not, but if they don't break the disc. The players that they put in them were kind of poor quality as well, anyway, and they'd mess up. But you can put much better quality replacements in them. But
Yeah, I
just
would
trying to even find the game itself is hard because it came out, in 1983, when the crash hit the market, and it had a very initial a good initial run, but then the market crashed, and it just didn't matter anymore. Just games in general. But
Yeah, I mean, I think it's kind of weird that there's like laser discs. That just blows my mind.
I
But
mean, it's
when did
think
a
about it with. Oh, go
sorry
ahead.
sorry when did a when did Time Warp come out? Because there was a Time Warp there too. I'll
Yeah.
probably maybe include footage in there too. Like we went to Chicago and both
We
time
did.
both Dragon Slayer and Dragon Slayer 2 Time Warp was there. Time Warp did not work, probably because the now that I'm thinking back, probably the laser disc was a piece of crap.
No, it wasn't that, because the footage looked fine. I think
Oh, it was the
it was a control problem. Like the one of the I think the joystick might not have been working, or maybe the motherboard that controls it all was messed up, but
Oh yeah, all right.
yeah. It was cool to see that in real life. That is
Yeah.
one I've never seen before in person.
Yeah, it was good to see that too. I never saw a Dragon's Lair reel before in my life. When did Dragon's Lair 2 come out? Did it come out like during the crash? 'Cause I think that like from the story aspect of it, I think that's and the gameplay of it of what I've heard. I heard that was like a lot better than Dragon's Lair, I thought.
It's different. It's not bad necessarily. It's better in some ways. It came out in 1991, I believe.
Oh, 1991. Okay. Like
Yes.
after the crash, I guess. Or was it during the
That
crash?
was, oh yeah. That was way after the crash. The
Okay, good.
crash ended because Nintendo brought gaming back in 85 with the NES. But we're not going to get into that today. Yeah, so overall, Dragon's Lair is a cool one. If you ever find a Dragon's Lair machine, play it.
Heck yeah. Th
You
this is a
can
fantastic
find
story.
it is, and you can find the game on probably on the PC online. You can get DVD versions of it. I know you can get it on the Sega CD if you have that, which is kind of obscure. But that version's kind of grainy looking. It does work though. Panasonic 3DO, I think, has one. I know they have Space Ace, but I don't know if they have Dragon's Lair. Anyway, there were several on MS-DOS, I believe. And yeah, just there's a lot of ways to access the game. So if
With
you
all of
find
our
it,
excitement about this, I think we forgot to mention the story for our new listeners, I guess. So, let me just run down the story, I guess. So, it's pretty much a knight that captured princess type of thing and all that, where the I forgot the name of the guy, but
Dirk the Daring.
what?
Dirk the Daring is his name.
Dirk the Daring. Okay, so Dirk the Daring, he has to rescue Daphne from this evil dragon, I guess, and that's pretty much it. All
Singe the Dragon
Singe the
and Dirk
Dragon.
the Daring. Yep.
And yeah, that's pretty much it. You would think that was boring, but heck no, it's not. Like the spectacular animation and all that, like the different ways, it's very creative. It was almost like an acid dream. Time Warp is clearly an acid dream, but we're not reviewing that. We're reviewing.
Is even more of an acid dream than the first one. The
Oh yeah,
first
that's.
one, I don't even know if I'd call it a dream.
It's like a basic
It felt
story
more like
almost, but it's like a
more
magical
like
type of
a
story.
distinct fantasy adventure game,
Yeah, but
but
the second one's like
yeah.
clearly an acid dream. Beethoven flying through the air with like piano and all stuff. But anyway, I love
Yeah.
Dragon Slayer. It's probably my favorite arcade game of all time. I probably said that about some other things, maybe.
You probably did.
I don't know.
I think
One of my li I remember I had a list. I don't remember where I put it, but it was like I remember Dragon Slayer being clearly on top, and or clearly like one of them on top, and it's absolutely spectacular. Like this is my favorite arcade game. I'm honored and excited that I got to play it, and I'm giving this an A plus. Like you're A plus plus plus. It's that great. It's that great of
It is.
a game.
I will be giving it the exact same thing because it really is. It's very fun, and you can't beat it. I just wish it was a little bit cheaper to own because
I mean, everyone
trying to
wants
buy
it, and
one,
it's
like,
rare.
yeah, it's easily 1,000 plus. And if you find a Dragon's Lair for less than a grand, please let me know because I will put some money down on that.
I would assume that if they did, they'd probably buy it for themselves. But yeah, let me know
Probably.
too, because I want one. Anyway, guys, comment, subscribe, let me know what you guys think of Dragon Slayer. Does it rock? Does it suck? If you say suck, well, we're gonna have an argument on your hands. Comment, let me know, subscribe, ring that bell. More reviews coming your way. Take care,
Yep.
guys.
Take care, everyone. Bye-bye for now.